Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about one-on-one roleplay rules. When it comes to one-on-one roleplay, we need a way to effectively communicate what we're looking for in a partner. So I'm going to share with you something that I use to attract the type of roleplay partners that I'm looking for, and you can use that too. We're going to talk about how I put together my one-on-one roleplay Bible. This is a living document, and you can use a Google Doc, a website, a blog, anything where you can go in and easily edit the content and also send a link to other roleplayers. I personally recommend using Google Docs for this. It's free, it's easy. Pretty much everyone has a Google account, so that means you probably already have access to this, even if you've never used it. And it's something that people are used to seeing, but really you can use anything. This document has a few different elements, and exactly what elements you include are going to depend on what kind of role player you are. So you might not include every element that I talk about in yours, or you might include things that I don't spend a lot of time talking about. And this is part one of the series where we start to talk about those elements. And the first element that we're going to talk about is your rules. This is the most important part of your one-on-one roleplay Bible. And no matter what situation you're in, this should be the very first page. When you're writing these rules, you should be thinking about three things. Number one, what are your requirements? For example, do you only roleplay with people who are over the age of 18? Number two, what do you expect from your roleplay partner? For example, how often do you expect them to reply to you? And then number three, what can a roleplay partner expect from you? So for example, how long are your posts on average? Think deeply about these things when you're writing your rules and lay them out in an easy to read fashion. It can be really tempting when you're writing up your rules to try to be as accommodating as possible so that you can attract as many roleplay partners as possible. But this is a mistake. You're not trying to attract anyone and everyone. You're trying to attract the exact type of role player who is best for you. Think of trying to attract role play partners in the same way as trying to attract a potential date on a dating app. Do you want messages from every single Tom, Dick, and Harry? Probably not. You probably just want messages from the Tom, Dicks, and Harrys who are the type of person that you would like and they would like you back. So as an example, let's go through some of my rules to give you specific ideas. Now, when it comes to one-on-one roleplay, I don't roleplay with anybody under the age of 18. So my very first rule is that my roleplay partner needs to be 18 plus. This way, if any teenagers are reading my one-on-one roleplay document considering roleplaying with me, then they immediately know that continuing is a waste of their time. I'm not going to roleplay with them anyway, so they can move on and find somebody more suitable. The second rule describes how I roleplay, to set expectations with others. So it says, I RP using third-person past tense. I usually reply with single para, but it depends on the setting and thread. First post is to set the scene and is usually longer than subsequent posts. When it comes to rules like this, make sure you're representing yourself accurately. This is going to require some self-reflection, but if you put in the work now to make sure that your rules are accurate, what's going to happen is you're going to attract people that come in with correct expectations, and it's going to reduce the number of people that start to role play with you and then realize that what they're getting isn't really what they thought they were going to get, and it will also help cut down on the number of people ghosting you because of setting those expectations properly. So make sure you explain how you actually role play, not how you want to role play. Also, when setting expectations, it's useful to give people an idea of how to get your attention and make you interested in them. So that brings me to my third rule. I love AUs and I'm open to plotting all kinds of AUs. If you want to plot with me, your best bet is proposing something like that. So for me, if you want to get my attention and make me like you first off the bat, propose an AU idea. This rule helps ensure that people who contact me are similar types of role players to me, which is what we want. We want the people messaging you to be the types of people that you would like to role play with. My fourth rule helps people understand to be specific when contacting me, so I'll read that one too. Most of my muses are open, multi-ship, and multiverse. If you want to interact with one of my selective muses, please mention the muse specifically because I will not suggest them when we're plotting. Reading this, you know when you scroll down the document further, you're going to be seeing a muse list, and you should pay attention to the status of those muses, because that's going to help you know if you don't pick a specific muse from my list, who I might pick in return when we're plotting. Then my last rule. This is here to discourage anyone who's super busy to not contact me, because the roleplay is going to get dropped anyway. So here's what that one says. I have a short attention span. After about a month, if I have no reply on our thread, I will drop it. If you want to keep anything I dropped, just let me know. I'm happy to keep things for hiatus or whatever, so long as I know you're still interested. If I do drop something, we can always make a new thread later. This also lets you know I'm pretty ghost friendly. So even if I drop something, that doesn't mean that I've dropped you, just that particular roleplay. And we can always start something new later whenever you're not so busy. Now, exactly what's in your rules is going to vary a lot. So that's where we want to think about those three questions that we posed at the beginning of the video. What are your requirements? What do you expect out of a roleplay partner? And what can a roleplay partner expect from you? I would recommend not making your rules too long, because this is potentially the first thing someone is going to read about possibly role-playing with you, so you want to make sure that they're left with a good, quick impression. If you have more than 10 rules, or your rules take more than a few minutes to read, I would consider looking through them and seeing if there's anything that you can cut. See if there's anything that doesn't really necessarily need to be said in the rules. For example, are there things that you sometimes care about but not always? Are there maybe things that are more appropriate to discuss in DM one-on-one with a person as opposed to putting them in your rules? Is there anything in there that makes you sound overly passive or overly aggressive? If the answer is yes to any of these, consider if they really need to be in your rules or if they're better to put in when you're first talking to someone and trying to decide if you're going to start a roleplay with them. So those are my tips on how to put together your one-on-one roleplay rules. If you've used rules before, let me know down below how you like to do it. And if you've not done it before, does this video make you consider potentially putting together some one-on-one roleplay rules? Let me know all of that down below. And remember to like if you like this video, comment down below with any questions that you have, subscribe for more videos, click the bell for notifications, all the links to my social media down in the doobly-doo. Thank you so much for watching and make it a great day.